Yeah, so the apple experiment, the famous apple experiment, had its origins in science fiction as well. We in the lab, we were actually talking about a lot of different things, all kind of at the same time. There's an area of regenerative medicine that utilizes donated organs to build new organs for patients in the future. And this process involves something called decellularization. That's the removal of all the cells and DNA from a donor organ. And what you're left with is this mesh-like scaffold, right? It's this extracellular matrix. And you can populate that back with, say, stem cells or other therapeutic cells and potentially grow a patient-specific new organ. And we were curious about that process. At the same time, for some reason, we were talking about this movie, Little Shop of Horrors, where you've got this human eating plant, and we started wondering, well, could we grow that thing in the lab, right? Which again is kind of an out there question, but in my lab, that's fair game. So what was the hypothesis? Well, we hypothesized that if we could decellularize the plant, we would be left with a matrix made of cellulose, and we would be able to grow muscle cells into that cellulose. And although we haven't created the man-eating plant yet, we have figured out how to grow mammalian cells into cellulose scaffolds. And in fact, we've even figured out that it's possible to implant these scaffolds into the body relatively safely, and the body will accept them and vascularize them. And suddenly, by accident, we've developed a material that has huge therapeutic and regenerative potential in the clinic, and we're now headed towards developing our first clinical trials.